الحمد لله نحمده واستعينه واستهديه واستغفره واؤمن به جل وعلا ولا اكفره واشهد ان لا اله الا الله واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله ارسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. All praise belongs to Allah. We praise Him, we seek His help, His assistance, and His guidance. We believe in Him and do not disbelieve in Him. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a servant and messenger. Allah sent him, that is Muhammad, with deen al-haq, the religion, the way, the methodology of truth. This way of life known as Islam will rise to its proper position in this world, whether the mushriks like it or not. Amma ba'd, fa inna astaqal hadith kitabullah wa awtaqa al-ura kalimatu taqwa wa khayru milali milatu Ibrahim wa khayru sunani sunatu Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ashraful hadith dhikrullah wa asanu irtasasi هذا القرآن وخير الأمور أوزموها وشير الأمور مهتداتها وأسن الهدي هدي الأنبياء وأشرف الموت قتل الشهداء وأما الأمر دلالة بعد الهدى وخير الأمال ما نفاها وخير الهادي ما أثباها وَشَيْرُّ أَمَّا الْكَابِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the most truthful of discourses is Kitabullah, or the Book of Allah. The most trustworthy word is Taqwa, or fear of Allah. The best of the community is the community of Prophet Ibrahim. The best way of life is the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The remembrance of Allah is the most glorious of all things. The best of all narrations is Quran. The best acts are those requiring the highest degree of will and determination. The worst acts are those based on innovation. The best way of life is the one adopted by the prophets of Allah. The most glorious death is the death of the martyr. The most wretched blindness consists of going astray after finding the right way. The best acts are the ones that yield benefits. The best guidance is that which people may be able to follow. The worst blindness is the blindness of the heart. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna Allah yahmuru bil adli wal ihsani wa itai dil qurba وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَالْبَاغِي يَعِذُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. Allah commands justice, the doing of good, and liberality to kith and kin. He forbids all shameful deeds and injustice and rebellion. He instructs you that you may receive admonition. فَمَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَدِيَهُ يَشْرَى سَتْرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ. Those whom Allah in His plan willeth to guide, He opened their breast to Islam. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. O you believe, fear Allah as He should be feared, and do not die except in the state of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاتَسِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيًّا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. And hold fast altogether by the rope which Allah stretches out for you, and be not divided amongst yourselves. And remember with gratitude Allah's favor on you. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنكَرِ وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ. You are the best of peoples, evolved for mankind, enjoining what is right, forbidding what is wrong, and believing in Allah. Akulu kauli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu idha nudiya lis-salawati min yawm al-jumu'ati fas'au ila dhikrillahi wa dharu al-bay'a dhalikum khayrun lakum in kuntum ta'lamun. فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَوَاتُ فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. O you who believe, when the call is proclaimed, prayer on Friday, the day of assembly, hasten earnestly to the remembrance of Allah, and leave off business and traffic that is best for you if you but do. And when the prayer is finished, then may ye disperse through the land and seek the bounty of Allah and celebrate the praises of Allah often without stint that you may prosper. But when they see some bargain or some amusement, they disperse headlong to it and leave thee standing. Say, the blessing from the presence of Allah is better than any amusement or bargain, and Allah is best to provide for all needs. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Al-Yawm akmaltu lakum dinakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'amati wa raditu lakum al-Islam adina. This day have I perfected your religion for you, completed my favor upon you, and have chosen for you Islam as your religion. This is said to be the last part of the Quran that was revealed. It is said by some commentators to have been revealed 62 days before the end of the Prophet's life. And when many learned people of the time were asked about it, or some had asked the Prophet, peace be upon him, himself, as it has recorded, what was the meaning of this? It says, especially Umar said, this was the signified the end of the Prophet's mission and the end of his life, because his mission was finished. That's what this is saying. This day have I perfected your religion for you, completed my favor upon you, and chosen for you al-Islam ad-Dina. Islam is the way of life. So completed means the religion is perfected. There's no revelation coming after that. There's no need for any more hidayah. The religion is fulfilled, completed, and developed. There's another one that was revealed. Some say at the time of the conquest of Mecca. But the people forgot about it. إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحُ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ تَوَّابًا. When Allah's help and victory comes, now you have to remember, after the years of exile and the, that's 10 years, and then the 13 years of persecution in Mecca, that in the 8th year of the Hijra, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam Jesus came to Mecca, the conquest of Mecca, and everybody, the flags of every group, people is coming and their flag is draped and they're basically in submission to Islam. So at this time, this ayat or this surah comes, or this in full, complete surah. When Allah's help and victory comes, and you see all of these people coming to the religion of Allah, celebrate the praises of Allah. Don't celebrate yourself. I did this, I pulled it off. This is big. And when you see these people coming in crowds, celebrate the praise of Allah. Allah is all forgiving and most merciful. That is one that was revealed too, but many people forgot it and they remembered it the last of the mission. But this is for us too. Today we want to talk briefly about your life, your salvation, not necessarily the whole Ummah, and you know, we're constantly talking about the mission and the goals and the striving. But this says, this day have I perfected your religion. It also means that this is directly to each and one of us. We need to look nowhere else for any addition to our religion. We don't have to look in the Bible, the Bhagavad Gita, we don't have to look nowhere, right? For any extension or explanation. This day have I perfected your religion for you, completed my favor for you, and chosen for you Islam. Now, the thing is, what are we going to do about it? You know, one of our famous hadith that we like, the hadith Qudsi, we read the beginning portion of it many times. I treat my servants according to his expectation of me, and I am with him when he remembers me. This is about expectation. There was a study done in Oakland, 1968, Dr. Rosenthal, I think it was, in Oakland Unified School District. They took a group of teachers, and of course they told them that they were selected because they were the best teachers in Oakland Unified School District. Then they gave them a group of students, and they told the students, they told the teachers that we are giving you the best students in Oakland Unified School District. They have more ability to learn and to grasp things, and we're giving them to you. At the end of 1 year, those students had progressed on an average of 3 years each. They had moved up in one educational year, basically 9 months. They had improved 3 years as a general rule. They came back to the teachers and they told them, well, this is the result of our experiment with you, that your students have performed extraordinarily. They have increased on the average 3 years per person in 1 year. And they said, well, it was nothing new. Especially you gave us the best students in the Oakland Unified School District. They said, no, we didn't. We chose their names out of a hat. Then they said, well, it's very simple. We are the best teachers in the Oakland Unified School District, so therefore the result was a foregone conclusion. They said, no, that's not true. We chose your name out of a hat, too. What was the factor? The only factor. There was no factor with the students themselves, they knew nothing about it. But the teachers had high expectation. They expected the most out of the students, and they expected the most out of themselves. So when they came to a stumbling block, this guy is not getting it. This child is not picking up on it. Well, he's not slow, he's one of the smartest students, so he can get it. I have to look in myself and find a way to get that message to the student, right? So the only one that was aware of anything was the teacher. They had high expectations of themselves and of the students. That produced 3 times the normal growth with high expectations. Now, what about self-expectations? What do we expect out of ourselves? Right? What do we expect out of life? We have the whole world here. Now, you got to remember now. Years ago, everything for us was determined by our race, our color, where we live, the car we drive. Everything was determined by segregation and the law of the land. Most of it. The job you had, where you worked, where you lived, was mainly determined by the system, by the society. That's not necessarily true now. It has a big effect. But you know what the greatest determining factor is? What we believe about ourselves. What we expect of ourselves. But more important than that, we're Muslims. And Allah says, this is Allah speaking, because this is a hadith, but it's a hadith Qudsi. That means Allah is speaking through the Prophet, peace be upon him. Right? So it's a holy, it's a sanctified, special hadith. So I, Allah, treat my servant according to his expectation of me. What does that mean? Can we expect more of Allah than he is? No, you can't, your mind is not even fixed. It can't do that, right? You can't say with your vocabulary and what have you, technically who Allah is and what his existence means. You can only go through the attributes that is given to us. That's the best we can do. The hadith says that if all the trees were pens and all the oceans were ink, you could not exhaust the knowledge of Allah. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave each one of us 7 heavens and 7 earths that we can visualize, of our own, each one of us have 7 universes we see in the telescope. Of our own, it wouldn't exhaust Allah. It wouldn't have no effect on Allah. Can you imagine the grandioseness of Allah? No. But what are we asking Allah for? Oh, Allah, help me get this new job. I'm going down and get a little interview. Oh, Allah, help me with this interview. Oh, Allah, my car's acting up. Can you help me get it down to the place and fix the individual? Right? Oh, Allah, help me avoid any problems with the police. If I happen to stumble in jail, oh Allah, speak to the parole board, right? Soften up their hearts. And this is what we pray for. You know why? Because this is what we expect of Allah. We ask of Allah things that we expect, that we don't ask of anything in relationship to who Allah is. And we have to remind ourselves, because we all do it. I have to remind myself, stop asking for this mumbo jumbo. Oh Allah, help us fix the world into a beautiful place for the human and the animal life. Help us to make this something that history would be proud of.
And that's still small. Remember, Allah says, I am to the believer what he expects of me.
Expectations. That means it's mostly how we see ourselves. And remember, self-image determines, it's like that thermostat on the wall. Wherever we set it, you know, cool air come in, cool it down, then it goes off, then it gets hot again. That thermostat sets, wherever we set it, that's where it's going to hit in. Our thermostat for life is our self-image, how we see ourselves. If you're a salesman, are you a $10,000 a month salesman, $20,000 a month salesman, right? How you see yourself, that's how you're going to perform. If you outperform, you're a $10,000 a month salesman, you make $20,000, it'll either spur you to make more, or you might say, slow down for a while and fix your records. Why? To get back where you belong, to make your averages about right. Because that's your self-image, how I see myself. Self-expectations. Remember we went over before about internals and externals. These are different types of people who have various views of life. Externals are those that they say everything I am comes from the outside. It's the weather. It's the people, it's the job, right, that determines everything. Those are what we call externals. They believe and they act according to that idea that everything that I am really is a part of the external environment. Now then there's internals. Internals believe that where I live, the car I drive, the education that I have, the wife and children that I have, all of that depends on me. They're internal. So if an external come up against some, he said the challenge is too great, it's too big, because look at all of those people, look at all of the stuff that I have to face with. When the internal faces the same thing, he says, I've got it within myself to deal with all of that and all of them. Because the outcome is not determined by them, it's determined by my internal self, right? So that's the difference between externals and internals. Internals are those that look at all of those challenges, all of those obstacles. And it's like last week's sermon that they're events that you ride on. They're your bus ride, your airplane ride to your next level. That's an internal. So today we're talking about something that mostly everybody, this is a personal business. So today we're talking about our life. And not the great movement that we should all share in and be a part of, but what about me? What about your life? How do you want to live? Where do you want to live? What level of Islam do you want to exist on? You know who chooses that? You and I choose that. Exactly the level that we want to be on, we choose that for ourselves. It's living by design. You have the right to design your own life. Now there's such things as evolutionary goals and an evolutionary life. When you first face challenges, you
you learn and you grow and you develop and you learn and you acquire certain skills how to navigate in life. So you have modest goals in the beginning. But as you learn more, you realize that the only thing, the main limitation you have in life is self-limitation. Self-limitation. How you see yourself. Do I have the ability? What do I want to be in life? Do you know that that's the heck of a thing for you and I to face? That the house I live in, the car I drive, the family I have, the education I have, everything is determined by me. But they won't let too many black people in that school. Well, to find another one, self-educate yourself. They can't stop it. Right? Well, they won't let me join their company. Well, build your own company yourself. They can't stop you from building. They won't let me join their company. They won't let me build their team, play on their team. Yeah? Go get some of the other brothers and make your own team. Say, y'all scared to play us. Y'all not certified. Well, y'all scared to play a non-certified team? What's wrong with y'all? Y'all got all these credentials and flags, and you scared to play us? And we just got raggedy tennis shoes and everything? What's wrong with y'all? We'll try you. We'll see. And you go out there and whoop. And you got your own team. And you challenge everybody. Y'all ain't nothing. Y'all got all these qualities. You're talking about you the heavyweight championship. You ain't fought nobody. You ain't fought me. I'm the heavyweight champion. You ain't listed on our chalkboard. What? So you scared to fight a non-listed brother. Right? You can't talk that way to me. I'll fight you. Anytime, man. You welcome, man. He said, nah, y'all gotta get on my list. Right? Why not? If they don't let you in their clubhouse, you build your own club. Negroes look silly. I want to eat in your restaurant. Long time ago. And you go and beg the people to eat, and then you order the food. They don't want you there, and they cook the food back there, and you can't see them, and they bring it out there for you to eat. If you don't want me here, buddy, I cook my own food. Build my own restaurant. You can't cook no way. You know, I had some friends from South Africa. They were down in Atlanta. They said, on the way back, when you eat, why don't you just try to stop at Cracker Barrel? I said, Cracker Barrel? It's just like what it says, crackers. They got cracker, you know what I mean? They got bland food. I never ate them, but I took people there one time. They were saying they have, I said, this food look like covered wagon food, you know what I mean? Bunkhouse food, you know, like in the old days, you know? And I tasted some of it. I said, this gravy tastes like the blandest. And that's when I got back down in Atlanta. I said, man, y'all, with all that good food y'all have in South Africa, y'all like Cracker Barrel food? I said, Cracker Barrel food is what it says, Cracker Barrel. What does that mean? I said, forget it, I don't want to go into no history, but it's Cracker Barrel. That's what they think. That's what I understand. They're saying who they are. And you like that? You know the food in South Africa, the Indian food is wonderful. You know what, we always got a little spot up here where we Negroize. Make your life a great life. As somebody said that where the greatest ideas are. You know what they said? The greatest ideas are in the cemetery. everybody had great ideas, that they never acted on those great ideas. And they took them to the cemetery with them. They died without fulfilling. Think of all the great ideas all of us have had, great ideas. And we look up 3 years later and this guy that just got rich, his Mr. Mellon Kaufman made $62 billion of the same idea I had running through my brain in the Southeast, right? Or you see other people acting on things you thought about 10 or 15 years ago. Think of all the ideas, successful ideas, that we've had and we've never acted on. So you have to make your life great. And then while you're doing that, have fun at it. Have fun in life. No matter what life dishes you out, you jump on it like it ain't nothing. So, this expectation is what I expect of my life, what I expect to do, and when I face challenges and obstacles, I feel that I have the ability, I have the expertise to meet those challenges, overcome those challenges, adapt to those challenges, and come out better each time. And that every obstacle and every challenge is a plateau or a level of development for me. This is what we have to look about our life. Remember, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the best of this world and the best of the next world. The best of this world, or the best of the next world, and the best of this world. All that depends on our understanding. There are certain levels that we will probably encounter. One is when we accept Islam fully. Now there's going to be a transcendence, transition. Now remember, when we accepted Islam, now everything that we did in the dunya was basically wrong. The food we ate was haram. We had two or three girlfriends and wasn't married to none of them, right? And had kids scattered around. Sometimes we took care of them, sometimes we didn't. The things we drank. Watching football, a bottle of beer, not a bottle of beer, excuse me, a stack of beer, right? Do people still do that? When it's come time for football, you could see it, they got a cooler or they got a refrigerator, and they do it the night or the day before, cool beer. And then they might have a beer party. You know, the brothers are all them pizzas. When I first come to D.C., the brothers used to have those, I ain't gonna mention who they was, but the brothers would get together on Saturdays and they would have pizzas and they would watch football, boxing, everything. And although this was over almost 30 years ago, I went to one and they had Michael Jordan, you know, one of the early videos. Now remember, I'm in movement, I haven't seen any sports or anything. I have paid no attention for like 20 years. And they showed this guy, and he would, I said, that nigga is fine. I had never, you know, they was all dunking a little bit back in the 70s, but this guy, he was running, and sometimes he looked like he was climbing in the air. I said, that's one of them funny style white folks videos. Don't nobody do that stuff. He can't do that. And I kept seeing him. I said, the guy's real. And they would have, this was an Islamic movement in D.C.
They would have giant pizzas.
And then when we opened a little masjid around the corner, they went by a big screen TV, and every Saturday morning was going to use the masjid for it. I said, don't sound like there's not quite enough religion in that. We're going to have all these pizzas. They want to turn the masjid into a sports club. You know what I mean? They weren't going to drink no beer or nothing, but everything would be there but the beer. Big screen TV, so then I said, no, we got to kind of just do our little prayers and stuff like that. So they stopped coming. But anyway, that was the movement when I got here. Believe it or not, that's people here right now know it. That was the movement. They know who was doing it. I said, man, this is a serious movement. In other words, the great movement had been diverted. The same thing can happen in your individual life. You could be headed somewhere and all kind of stuff can come and divert you from your goal. But now as you moving along in life, remember evolution. Not revolution, evolution. You acquire and you move into some things that you want, and then you ask for more. You ask yourself for more. You ask Allah for more. Pretty soon, you become limitless. That's transition from jahiliyyah to deen. Transformation is that you become a transformed person. What you was before, remember before when we were non-Muslims, our friends and family understood us and everything, right? Then, when we accepted Islam, said, no, I ain't gonna drink no more. I can't be drinking, I can't. Man, that's a good look. No, I don't do that no more. You don't blow. Well, what about Salome? That was your girl. She called us, wanted to see y'all that good. I'm not married to her, I can't go by that. I said, well, what is wrong with you? You don't drink. And they talking to each other now. The boy don't drink. He don't get high. And he's talking about marrying a girl. If he ain't married to her, he can't mess with her. That boy went crazy. Isn't that what I read to say? I said, that boy, that is long. Boy, that brunette boy used to be the smartest Negro in D.C. Now, he done went around all them 12 kids he had, all the girls, and now he done bought a van and he'd take them down to Wonderland every weekend and all that, trying to be a good dad, make up for being a fool. He's now a real fool. Before, he was a faking fool because he was telling all the girls, yeah, I love you. They tell us, I love you. And they was giving up everything. He having all these kids. And now, when you tell them, I love you, the fool mean it. That boy went crazy. Is that what they say about us? You don't do what? Expectations. I'm going to close with this. The hadith is clear. Hadith Qudsi, I, Allah, am to the believer what he expects of me. So, we're just saying, let's live a better, more improved life. Let's don't come here and be normal and do what everybody else do. You know, the big white folks, they say, if you want to be average, put your feet in ice water and your head in an oven, and you'll be average. They hate average. You're nothing. They say, we don't care what they say. But we're saying live the kind of life you want, but don't limit yourself. If there's something that you think would be an improvement, a betterment, we ask Allah for the best of this world and the next world. We don't have to suffer necessarily. We have to struggle. It doesn't say, the Quran don't say, I made man to suffer. It says, I made him to struggle and challenge things, right? Not to just suffer. A challenge is not suffering unless that's the way you see it. I am suffering. Well, that's too bad for you, because Allah made you big enough to handle anything one man can put out for you that you as another man can handle. Right? So, let's live the life you want to live. Oh Allah, we seek thy refuge from anxiety and grief. We seek thy refuge from life, the strength of nations. We seek thy refuge from cowardice and niggardliness. We seek thy refuge from being overpowered by death and the oppression of men. Oh Allah, suffice us with what is lawful, keep from us what is prohibited. With thy grace, make us free from one of what is besides it. Ameen. Be kind to see.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.